so nice of you to have me here. Thank you. My name is Carl Paladino, and I'm from Buffalo, New York. I'm running for governor. I don't like using the word running. I'm looking to serve you for 4 years. I'm looking to serve the people of the state of New York, and that means all the people. I went to St. Bonaventure University, Syracuse University College of Law. I served the United States Army for about 11 years total, active in reserve, and retired as a captain. I have 4 children, 4 grandchildren, 1 wife, a dog named Duke, who's my friend. I spent the last 38 years of my life practicing law for the first 15 and slowly evolving into the real estate development business. Today, we have a business that manages, leases, and develops approximately $500 million worth of real estate that we've assembled over that period of time. We employ about 450 people. I'm not a politically correct person. I'm unintimidatable. My wife went and looked that up in the dictionary. She said, it's not a word. And I said, but I like it so much, I'm going to just keep using it.
Can you repeat that in here?
I'm unintimidatable. Oh. And my wife went and looked it up in the dictionary and said it's not a word. I decided to run for governor after I had watched Mario rise to the top on the Andrew rise to the top on the Democratic end, and after I had met Mr. Lazio. Those events, together with an experience where I learned a lot about mortality, I learned about the fragility of life, and I knew that life is just a sprint. Combined with some urging by some friends who knew that my unique character could do the job. I was never disposed to be in elected office. This is the first and the last time that I'm going to run for elected office. I'm only going to serve 4 years. I'm going to go to Albany, and I'm going to restructure the government. I'm going to lower spending by 20% in the first year. I'm going to lower the taxes by 10% in the first year. I didn't say cut. I didn't say put a cap percentage on an increase like Andrew is saying. Andrew's saying he's going to gradually increase spending, gradually increase taxes. I'm going to cut. I'm going to cut out agencies. I'm going to cut out a lot of political jobs and positions that have grown over the years that have resulted in a government of 298,341 people. A government that our legislature and governor over the last couple of years couldn't find one employee to lay off. Nevertheless, they raised our taxes and fees $15 billion during that period of time. A government that gives us the most liberal social welfare and Medicaid benefits anywhere in America, for that matter in the world, and therefore invites, because of the right to travel under the 14th Amendment, invites every lame and disenfranchised person in America to come to New York and hop on the backs of our taxpayers. A government that has illustrated in its actions on moral, ethical, and legal grounds, an inability to properly police itself, crime, corruption, pay-to-play club, friends and family club, all that nonsense. It's going to go. It's going to disappear. We're going to restore in the hearts of people a grounded government that they can turn to and rest assured that they know where they go, where they're going in the future. Right now, people look at Washington, they look at Albany, and there's nothing grounded. It's chaos everywhere. They're talking directly in opposition to everything we learned. You see, I'm from the same place that you are. My dad taught me family values. He taught me how you take care of your family. Take care of the old when they get older. And there's no greater counsel than your grandparent can give to the grandchild. You know, we pain and we struggle to raise our children. We take them and we lead them down that path into life. We advise them. We cajole them to go to school to better themselves. And then what? Then that pain. We love them so much that we got to tell them to go away to find a fulfilling job. There's none here. There's nothing here for you. You've got to go away. And how many of us have friends that on a 6 o'clock at a Sunday night, they go and they look at the watch and they say, I'm sorry, I've got to go home now. Junior's going to call from Raleigh. I get to talk to my grandson for 5 minutes. That's the sadness of it. My dad was an immigrant. His brothers and my grandfather and grandmother were immigrants. They came here and they earned their place in America. They fought in the war. They served. They then worked very hard. They sent 3 kids to school. Sent us on to higher education. They gave us the ability to find a pathway into the world. And then we go there, we do our thing, and all of a sudden our governments leave us. They change the rules. Redistribution of wealth, Obamacare, mandates, Medicaid. Social welfare without a need to work to earn that check. That bothers us. Our society's upside down. I can assure you, gentlemen and youngsters here, I will put the government on the right path. I'll do that. A couple issues were discussed with me. One being the kosher inspections by the state government. I don't see any reason that wouldn't be maintained. Second issue, I've been involved in for many, many years. My heart goes out to those thousands of children we take every year and put into our dysfunctional urban school districts. The shame of it. And the liberal progressives, they want to keep it all going. They have no shame. Well, I am all for vouchers. I'm all for tax credits. Way there, we're going to continue to nurture and push for charter schools and hopefully loosen up the rules so that we can have religious charter schools. So you can count on me on that. I'm 100% with you on that issue. Third issue is the issue of gay marriage or civil unions. Many have heard me speak. I really until tonight, I didn't really distinguish and comprehend the term civil union, but now I do. I fit that right in with the term of gay marriage. I don't have one iota of respect for that personally. And if the legislature should pass a bill calling for gay marriage or civil unions, I will veto it. I stand firmly, without exception, against any form of abortion. And Sheldon Silver bothers me. So I'd be happy to take any questions anybody may have.